Dear students, I am continuing the problems on curve fitting. Equations we studied in the previous discussion. Those equations I will write once again in order to recall those equations and calculations for constants A, B, C using method of least squares. That is, here it is given as straight line. We have three different forms of curve fitting. Y is equal to AX plus B, Y is equal to AX square plus BX plus C, and Y is equal to A into X to the power B. As per your syllabus, VTU syllabus, these are the equations you have to study. Here two constants you have to calculate, A and B. Here three constants you have to calculate. Here two constants you have to calculate. But for this given data, you have to calculate only the equation of straight line along with the calculations of constants A, B, C. Then how these calculations of constants will work? Let us start with this data. Fit a curve in the form of straight line. That is, Y is equal to AX plus B. Whatever the form they give, either Y is equal to AX plus B or Y is equal to A plus BX. In any form, let them give. Then you need to calculate the values of the constants using that particular form and write the normal equations according to that form. In the solution, that is given, Y is equal to AX plus B, where A and B are obtained using normal equations as sigma y is equal to A into sigma x plus B into B into n, one equation, and another equation sigma x into y, A into sigma x square plus B into sigma x. In addition to the given columns are x and y. How many more columns you have to write? One is x square, making square of all these values, and another one is product, that is x into y. So let us write these number of columns. Then x and y, x square and x and y. Then you need to take these summations. Afterwards, substitute in these equations, solve these two equations simultaneously to get the values of two constants A and B. X value, that is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 14, 27, 40, 55 and 68. Next, x square, 1, 4, that is 9, 16 and 25. You need to multiply this. This is 14 into 1, 40, 27 into 2, 54, this is 120, this is 2, 4, 5 are 20, and then this is 220, and 68 into 5, that is 4, 6, 5 are 30, 34, 340. Then all the column summations you require. All these column summations you require, those summations are, this is 15, this is 204, this is 55 and this is 748. This is 748. Then after taking these values, you substitute in these equations, that is sigma y. Sigma y means 204. 204 is equal to A into sigma x, that is 15, plus of B into n, that is B into n means n is number of paired observations, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, that is 5 you have to write. And next is sigma x into y, that is 748 is equal to sigma x square, that is 55, into A plus of B into sigma x, that is sigma x is 15, that is 15 times B. Then if you solve these equations with the usual method, making any one of the coefficients same and then cancel it, and you will be getting the values of constants A and B. 13.6 is the value of A and B value is 0. Then your straight line equation y equal to ax plus b, y is equal to ax plus b, a value is 13.6, it is x, plus of 0 implies y is equal to 13.6 into x is there. This is your equation of straight line. And what kind of this equation? Y is equal to 13.6 into x. What kind of this equation is? This is an equation of straight line because degree is 1 and degree is 1 here. This is the equation of straight line, but on both sides there is no extra constant like this. It is there. Coincidentally, that second constant becomes a 0. Then this equation y degree 1 and x degree 1, this is called linear equation, and this is homogeneous equation of straight line which is passing through the straight origin like this, passing through the origin. And this equation is equation of straight line, and from this you calculate what is the value of y at x equal to 6. Then at x equal to 6 you substitute, that is 13.6 into 6. The final calculation value is 81.6 is the answer. Like this, different types of data. Even for the same data you can study the second degree parabola, second degree parabola equation, that is y equal to ax square plus bx plus c, like that. But I will take different type of data for studying the second degree parabola. Here fit a curve, second degree parabola, that is a non-linear equation. Second degree parabola is highest degree of x is 2 and other terms are not having 2. Then second degree parabola, y is equal to ax square plus bx plus c for the data given below, that is x and y values are given, 10, 14, that is 12, 17, 15, 23, 23, 25, and 20, 21. Here, as I told you that shortcut method to be used, shortcut method can also be used, but on the condition when x values are equally spaced. Here between 10 and 12, 2 units is the difference, 12 and 15, 3 units is the difference. So the difference is not uniform, then you cannot calculate, you cannot apply that procedure as shortcut method, means change of origin method. Only thing, the best method you can use is put central value this one and subtract the other values, then you can calculate. Instead of that, you go for direct calculations for solving three equations in the parabola. What are those three equations? Y is equal to ax square plus bx plus c, where a, b and c are obtained. Using normal equations using normal equations as sigma y is equal to a, that is a into sigma x square plus b into sigma x plus n into c. Next, sigma x into y, a into sigma x cube plus b into sigma x square plus c into sigma x is that. Sigma x square y is equal to a into sigma x to the power of 4 plus b into sigma x cube plus c into sigma x square. How many more columns you have to write in addition to the given data? You prepare those columns. X, y, x square, x cube, x to the power of 4, x into y, and then x square y. You are looking to these three equations. We need to write x square one term, next x cube, next x to the power of 4, next x into y, and x square into y. So these number of columns you prepare, and then take the summation in each column and then substitute in the given equation. Then take the entry of these values, that is 10, 14, 12, 17, next 15, 23, 23, 25, and 20, it is 21. Then go on making the values of this square and then all that. So I will be giving the summation values. That summation will be sigma x is equal to 80 and sigma y is equal to 100. Sigma y equal to 100, sigma x square is equal to 1398, sigma x cube is equal to, that is 26270, sigma x to the power of 4 is equal to 521202, and sigma x into y product, that is 1684, and sigma x square y is equal to 30648. Then you form the normal equations to calculate using method of least squares using those summations. That is, equation is like this: sigma y. Sigma y is 100 and sigma x is 80. Then sigma y, that is 100, is equal to a into sigma x square. Sigma x square means 1398 into x square. B into sigma x. Sigma x is 80 into b. This is into a. And c, n into c. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That is 5 into c. You have to write. Then second equation, that is sigma x into y. Sigma x into y means 1684 is equal to sigma x into y, that is a into sigma x cube. X cube is 26270 into a plus b into x square. B into x square is 1398 into b plus of c into sigma x. Sigma x is 80, then that is multiplied by c. And third equation, that is sigma x square y, that is 30648 is equal to a into sigma x to the power of 4. That is, x to the power of 4 means 521202. That is multiplied by a plus of b into sigma x cube. That is, b into sigma x cube means plus 26270 into b plus c into sigma, that is x square. C into sigma x square means 1398, that is into C. This is equation number 1, this is equation number 2, and this is equation number 3. When you solve these 3 equations, then you will be getting A is equal to, same type, solving, making the coefficient, one of the coefficients same, and then solve it, minus 0.07, and B is equal to 3.03, minus C is equal to minus 8.89. These are the calculations, and this is the equation of the parabola. Then you substitute in this equation of parabola as the values of ABC. Then Y is equal to A value, that is minus 0.07 into X square, and B value is 3.03 into X, and plus C value minus 8.89. minus 8.89 into C, that is C value, that means it is a totally constant. Therefore, this is the equation of second degree parabola when you have the set of data where shortcut method is not applied. This is the direct approach when you are going to use. And for any new calculation at x equal to some asking number, you can replace on the right side, and the corresponding value of y you can calculate. Then another problem let me give in the third curve fitting. The third curve fitting means that is exponential form. Fit an exponential form y is equal to a into x to the power b to the following data. So the following data means x and y values. X and y values are given like this: 1, that is 7.1, 2, 27.8, 3, that is 62.1, 4, that is 110, and 5, it is 161. Then in the solution, you need to write the equation of so exponential form and the corresponding normal equations after converting this into straight line form. That is, given y is equal to a into x to the power b, then log y is equal to log of a plus b into log x. Then this is capital Y, capital A plus B into capital X. This is exponential form is reduced to the straight line form. Then the normal equations are, means A and B, that means capital A and small b, are obtained. As sigma Y is equal to whatever the normal equations already we have defined for equation of straight line, you go for the same and then work out for normal equations. Sigma y is equal to n into a plus b into sigma capital X. Another equation, sigma x into y is equal to a into sigma x plus b into sigma, it is x square. Then you need to prepare the columns for this. Which are the columns? X and Y as they are, you have to take, and then you have to apply for this one, X, this is log x and log y. That means log x, log y, this is for capital X, this is for capital Y. Then you need to write capital X square and X into capital X into capital Y. These columns you have to prepare and then calculate the corresponding constants. Then when you write this, all the calculations, then A, this is log A you are getting. That means A is capital A is equal to log small a. Capital A is equal to log small a. This implies calculation of A. That means how you have to avoid this. E to the power A, whatever this answer comes, e to the power A is equal to e to the power log of small a. Then e to the power capital A is equal to small a you are getting. Then A takes the value 7.173 and B value comes to be 1.952. Then the equation of straight line, then the equation of straight line in this form, which is reduced from exponential form, you can write directly after getting small letters of A and B. Y is equal to A value, that is 7.173 into x to the power b, that is x to the power b, that is the equation. X to the power b means x to the power 1.952. This is your curve fitting for exponential form. The first problem which was on straight line, second problem was on the second degree parabola, and third equation it is on exponential form. So where shortcut method is to be used, their x values should be equally divided. Now I'll give another problem with calculated values I will mention, then you can check all those calculations for constants in the respective equation. That is first equation as straight line, second equation as nonlinear form, it is second degree parabola, and third one is exponential form. So what are the values? I'll write some examples along with some answers. You can check all those calculated values. Example: fit a straight line and parabola. Two equations I am including in one data, parabola, to the following data. X and Y values. That is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. That is totally 6 values are there, and corresponding y values 4, 8, 10, 12, 16 and 20. Then here two equations we have to construct. One is equation of straight line and the other one is equation of parabola. That means you need to write the table, one common table for both the equations. let us use a shortcut method in this one. That means change of origin. In this case, here, what kind of values of x are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Equal difference of values of x. That means difference between two successive values is uniform everywhere. Then here we can use, it is not compulsory, but you can also use for this, because if you want to take x values, that is 6 to the power of 4 you have to go for second degree parabola. Instead of that, doing all that, you can go for a shortcut method. Here we can use change of scale method. As follows, change of scale method as follows means, let the equations, that means a straight line, y is equal to a plus bx and sigma y equal to n into a plus b into sigma x, and sigma x into y is equal to a into sigma x plus b into sigma x square. This is for straight line. And parabola, that is y is equal to a plus b into bx plus c into x square. Whichever the form you are going to write, accordingly normal equations you have to write. Then sigma y is equal to n into a plus b into sigma x plus c into sigma x square. Then sigma x into y is equal to a into sigma x plus b into sigma x square plus c into sigma x cube. Another equation, x square, that is x square y is equal to a into sigma x square plus b into sigma x cube plus c into sigma x to the power of 4. Now, let us change to new origin. Otherwise, change of scale, new origin, as u is equal to x minus mid x, divided by h. X minus mid x divided by h means x minus, middle value of x is, that is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. There are 6 values. Middle value of x is 3.5. It is 3.5 divided by h is 1 unit. That is x is equal to, u is equal to x minus, it is 3.5. Then wherever x is there, you have to use u equal to x minus 3.5. In terms of u, all these equations are to be defined. In terms of u means, in place of x, you have to write it as u. Accordingly, you have to prepare the table. What is the table? Let me write the table when you take this change of origin method. Then x you have to write as it is, y you have to write, and u is equal to x minus 3.5, and then y values are same. Then you treat this in place of x as u, and finally we can convert back in terms of x. That is forthcoming column, that means new columns you have to write, that is u square, u cube, u to the power of 4. Then x into y means u into y, then u square into y. Accordingly, the equations will go on changing. The equations will go on changing means the normal equation, even equation of straight line also. That means y is equal to a plus bx instead, a plus b into u, and y is equal to a plus b into u plus c into u square you are getting. Then corresponding normal equations in place of x, you must go on writing u. Then prepare the table. According to this, you prepare the table. Therefore, you take the same entry of that here and collect the summations and substitute in that. Then odd powers of u values will become 0. That is the advantage you have, so that you need not to solve 3 equations. From the 3 equations, middle equation will give only one answer. Therefore, x values 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and y values 4, 8, 10, 12, 16 and 20. Then, this is x minus 3.5, that is x is 1 first value, that is minus 2.5 and this one is 2 minus 1.5, this is 0.5, that is 3 minus 3.5 means minus, and this is 0. plus 0.5 and this is 5 minus 3, it is minus 1.5 and this is minus 2.5. That means these columns, y onwards you have to take summations, this becomes sigma y and this becomes sigma u and this becomes sigma u square, this is sigma u cube and this is sigma u to the power of 4 and this is sigma u into y and this is sigma u square, y is there. Then you need to write these number of calculations in the forthcoming column, that is u square, that is 2.25 minus 2.5 whole square and take the summation, u cube make it cube and then take the summation. After solving all these three equations, then you need to solve for a, b, c. Then a comes to be in the equations, that is sigma u cube and sigma u, this sigma u becomes 0, sigma u cube, this is also becoming 0, because exactly 50% of the values are positive and another 50% values are negative, this is plus sign, sorry, and these three values are the same as these three values with plus sign, therefore this summation is equal to 0. Obviously minus 1 whole cube means the answer once again comes to be negative, this is negative, this is negative and this is positive and rest of the two are positive, then its summation in the column as 0. Therefore in the normal equations these summations will become 0, then you will be getting in a very quicker method the values of the constants for the straight line. A is equal to, that is 1.3611 and B is equal to 2.9444, you are getting, and this is for straight line. Then you are going to write the equation for straight line, y is equal to 1.3611 plus 2.9444, this is the answer and this is multiplied by x, this is your equation of straight line. And similarly you are getting from the three normal equations, after substituting the odd powers of u is equal to 0, then you will be getting the values of constants a, b, c in this order. They are nothing but a equal to 1.254 and b is equal to 3.0255 and c is equal to minus 0.0116. Then second degree parabola y is equal to 1.254 plus 3.0255 x and minus 0.0116, this is the constant. This is called 1.254, that is into x square. This is called second degree parabola and non-linear equation. This is linear equation because x degree 1 and y degree 1, throughout the degree is same, that throughout the degree is not same, but x and y are having degree 1, so that it is a linear form and this is called non-linear form. but this equation of straight line is not passing through the origin. That is construction of equation of straight line and construction of equation of parabola. According like that, another data I will give. That is for exponential form. Another data I will write. Fit a curve. Y is equal to a into x to the power b. Given that x and y, that is 1, 2, 3, only 3 values are given, 1.7, 1.8 and 2.3. Already problem we have solved and we can follow the same type of equations. Then straight line you can study. That is x and y values 1, 3, 5, 7, 9. That is 1.5, 2.8, 4.0, 4.7, 6.0. For this, a is equal to 1.1845 and b is equal to 0.5231. Then y is equal to 1.845 plus 0.5231 into x. So this is equation of straight line. And one more on equation of parabola, that is x and y, that is for 20, 40, 60, 80, then 100 and 120. These values, y values will be 5.5, 9.1, 14.9 and 22.8, 33.3 and 46.0. Then for this you are getting a is equal to 0.00279, that is b is equal to 0.0122 and c is equal to 4.14. These are the three values. Then the second degree parabola, that is y is equal to a into x square plus b into x plus c into constant, that's all. This is the second degree parabola equation. Up to this one, module number 4 is explained. I would like to stop up to this one and study all these things in case if any discussion if you want, and you can go through the corresponding textbook that is given in B.S. Grewal, that is VTU prescribed book in the syllabus, and any queries are there then you can discuss with me, and so because email ID is already given in that, and you can discuss and you can send the queries so that I'll be able to answer. Thank you very much.